Madin 2000 is a leading router dynamic software developed by Delta.js. It allows modeling routers with active magnetic bearings. In this video, we demonstrate the design of radial bearing controllers and the lateral analysis. We use a prepared shaft. In the video about the lateral analysis, you can learn more about creating a shaft model. We now select the sensor and actuator positions of the magnetic bearings at different stations. This so-called non-collocation will be considered in the analysis. The magnetic pull is initially left at zero. Controllers need not yet to be defined. In the shaft plot, the sensors and actuators are marked with blue symbols. Before designing the bearing controllers, we need a basic understanding of the rotor's lateral vibration behavior. In the Campbell diagram for the free rotor, the critical speed of the first bending mode is close to minimum operating speed and will require good damping. The second bending mode should be sufficiently high above the maximum speed, because it is usually difficult to damp. To determine the achievable system damping for the first two bending modes, a damping variation analysis is carried out. The actuators of the magnetic bearings are replaced with springs of a low stiffness. A suitable variation range for the damping coefficient is set. The system damping of the first two bending modes at 100% speed can be seen in the frequency and damping diagram. For the stiffness variation analysis, the actuators of the magnetic bearings are replaced with undamped springs. A variation range for the stiffness coefficient is set. In the resulting frequency diagram for 100% speed, we can see at which stiffness values the natural frequency of each mode starts to increase. The observability and controllability report summarizes for the undamped modes the relative shaft displacement at the sensor and actuator positions, as well as the phase angle between sensor and actuator. This is important for the controller design strategy. Bearings can typically not damp modes if the controller transfer function has a phase angle between 0 and minus 180 degrees. Hence, a so-called phase roll-off is often used to pass this range at a suitable frequency. The second bending mode of the example rotor is not observable at the drive end bearing, and the roll-off of the DE controller can be set at this frequency. At the non-drive end bearing, the third bending is not controllable and the fourth bending not well observable, so that this frequency range can be used for a roll-off of the NDE controller. In the DE bearing GUI, we enter the magnetic pull and then open the controller GUI to implement our design strategy. All commonly used building blocks are available. The hardware characteristic is loaded via a MATLAB file. A time block accounts for zero order hold behavior and processing time. Hardware and signal processing calls a continuous drop of the phase angle over the frequency in the controller transfer function. A base block gives the bearing enough stiffness and a positive phase angle in the frequency range of the lower modes. In the transfer function plot, the range with a positive phase angle is marked by a bold line. Next, a filter for the phase roll-off is added. A low damping value makes the phase drop quickly, but at the cost of a strong gain increase, which should be avoided. Hence, we use more damping and get a more gradual phase reduction. After having also created the NDE controller, a closed-loop analysis of the damped lateral eigenvalues is carried out. In the result plot, the damped eigenvalues are shown together with the transfer functions. Above the operating speed range, there are some unstable modes, which are marked with red dots. Hence, it is necessary to improve the controllers with additional filters. Indeed, designing controllers is always an iterative process of setting filters and checking their impact on the lateral vibration behavior. For the final magnetic bearing controllers, all lateral analysis results must be assessed. The eigenvalue plot proves that all modes up to 2000 Hz are now stable. The maximum magnetic bearing sensitivity is less than 3 and thus meets the requirement of the ISO standard. Unbalanced excitation of the first bending mode yields a maximum amplification factor of 2.4 for the resonance peaks in the operating speed range, so that the requirement of API 617 for operation in resonance is met. The bearing forces are evaluated up to maximum operating speed and must be compared to the dynamic capacity of the bearings. To support the users in the controller design process, MADIN 2000 provides an automatic optimization tool. In this example, the system damping, the gain, the magnetic bearing sensitivity and the dynamic bearing force are combined in the goal function. The selected parameters of the controller building blocks are adjusted by the software such that the controller is optimized. The comprehensive list of features proves that there is no better commercial software for the analysis of rotors on magnetic bearings than MADIN 2000. And finally, it should be mentioned that the drop of the rotor into the auxiliary bearings can be simulated with the nonlinear capabilities of MADIN 2000. Are you interested in our advanced rotor dynamics software? Feel free to contact us for more information.